Sexual immorality, impurity, passions, even evil desire and covetousness, which is idolatry. On account of these, the wrath of God is coming. In these you two once walked when you were living in them. But now you must put them all away: anger, wrath, malice, slander, and obscene talk from your mouth. Do not lie to one another, seeing that you have put off the old self with its practices and have put on the new self. So we have an issue here, right? We have more than one self if you were counting the selves in the passage, right? We have an old self and a new self. So when we talk about the priority of being self, which priority, which self are we talking about? It's not the old self. Because in the passage itself, it said to what? Put that off. Put it to death. The old self. So we talk about self being number two. We're not talking about what I was saying in the beginning about, oh, I love me. I'm awesome. I'm the greatest. Everybody look at me. You know, I'm the center of attention. That's not what we're talking. We're talking about the new self.
Amen.
Those who are in Christ are a new creation. Right? The old is gone. The new has come. So we're talking about your identity in Christ. What does that mean? When you're in Christ, you are a child of God. You are His ambassador. You are not just anybody, right? You are a valued co-heir of a great inheritance. So we talk about self being number two. We're not talking about the old self, all those things that were listed. We're talking about the new self. So what does this new self include? Well, when you talk about yourself, right? We have parts, right? We have our body, mind, spirit. So when you talk about yourself and keeping that a priority, so that's what we're going to talk about. The physical, the emotional, and the spiritual. How do we make those a priority? How do they fit in to our life? So let's start with the physical, right? When it comes to yourself and making yourself a priority, let's start with the physical. Christians sometimes get into trouble with this one. And that's because we have this mindset that, okay, the spiritual is all I'm going to focus on, right? And the physical, I don't want to talk about the physical. The physical is dirty. The physical is filthy. It's corruptible. It's something I don't want to even, let's focus, forget about the physical. It doesn't make a lot of sense. Because when God created, right? He created a physical world, right? He created a physical world. And when He created that world, He said that that world was what?
Good.
He said that world was good. Now we know the story. We know what happens. Sin comes in and fractures everything, messes things up. But when God created the physical world, He created and He said it was good. So when you think about your body, when you think about the physical, right? Don't just cast it off. Don't just cast it aside. I'll give you another reason why. When Jesus Himself resurrected, He resurrected in a glorified body. He resurrected in a way that would pattern what would happen to us. We are going to have glorified bodies. There's this idea in Christianity that flows around that when we go to heaven, that it's some kind of, when we're there in eternity, and it's all said and done, and the earth has been recreated, and it's all, that's just going to be this airy, floating on clouds, just, you know, just this kind of wavy kind of thing. That's not it. If anything, at that time, things are going to feel more real than ever before.
Amen.
And we will have bodies. That's why you cannot discount the physical as you're here in the world today. Don't discount the physical. Now let's look at a scripture in 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 19 and 20. It says, "Or do you not know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit within you, whom you have from God? You are not your own, for you were bought with glorify God in your body. Our bodies are called the temple of the Holy Spirit. That means what goes into our body and what we do with our body are of consequence. Yes. They matter. They matter. They matter to God. So it's not something we should cast off. When you think about taking care of yourself as a priority, you have to think about the physical. What is it that I put in? What is it that I do with my body? Are they glorifying God? It's something to think about. So it's not just the physical part, right? There's also our emotional side. We did a series on stewardship about a month and a half ago, where we talked about stewardship of our resources. We talked about our tangible physical resources. We talked about intellectual resources, all kinds of things. And I had the privilege of talking about emotional resources. So when it comes to ourselves and caring for ourselves about emotions, here's another misconception, which I talked about in that last message. Some of us think that emotions are bad. You're like, emotions get me in trouble. And what do? We suppress our emotions. We say emotions mess things up. And we suppress all our emotions. And that will lead to an unhealthy emotional state. That will lead to an unhealthy self. When you try to live life subdued from feeling, you said, okay, well, when I feel, it gets bad, so I'm just going to not feel anything. But our emotions are not bad. They are yet again something that needs to be reclaimed and redirected for the glory of God. Not to mention the fact that the Bible commands us on numerous occasions to feel things. We're commanded to be joyful. We're commanded to be zealous, passionate. Oh, there's a whole litany of things, right? So when it comes to your emotional well-being, don't try and just suppress all your emotions and say, well, emotions are going to get me in trouble. They are part of the way God created you. But they need to be reclaimed and redirected for the glory of God. So you need to take care of your physical self. You need to take care of your emotional self. Then we have the spiritual. When it comes to taking care of yourself spiritually, there are certain things that have been called disciplines, right, that we can use in terms of our spiritual health. If you do some reading, you'll see there's, you can make the list very long, you can make the list very short, it depends. There are kind of three main ones, right, that we need to focus on. One is the scripture, right? The Bible, God's Word, and reading it. And these disciplines that we do to embolden and encourage our spiritual self, they can happen, they should happen privately and they should happen corporately. Right? So we should be spending time in the Word. When it comes to questions of what is my purpose? What is God's will for my life? Sometimes we get unsure. We don't know. We don't know what to do. We don't know what we should do. Why is reading God's Word so important? We find out, what does God like? What does God hate? What are the things that God values? Do you think that's valuable information when you're trying to figure out what the will of God is for you in your life? I think so, right? So, as far as a spiritual discipline goes, Bible reading is right there. And then there's also worship, right? That can happen privately, that can happen corporately. See, when we come to Christ, we are made spiritually alive. We were spiritually dead and then we were made spiritually alive. So when you read the Bible, it's not a mere exercise when you're spiritually alive. You are able to see in a way that you were unable spiritually alive. Your songs aren't just songs. They're transcendent, right? They you know, you can kind of almost feel your feet coming off the ground, right? There's more to it than just singing of songs. Why? Because now you are spiritually alive. And worship is a spiritual discipline that we should practice as well. And then, of course, prayer, right? Privately, corporately. You are now able to communicate. Being spiritually alive, you are now able to communicate with God in a different kind of way. You have access to the God of the universe when you are spiritually alive. So that's another spiritual discipline that we can take advantage of. Those are kind of big ones. You can do many, right? I'm going to talk about two more that are a little bit more under the radar, just for if you're thinking about what other spiritual disciplines might there be that I could take, that I could use in terms of building up my spiritual self. One is that of secrecy. You're like, secrecy? That doesn't sound like that. Let me explain what I mean by that, okay? So if you go to Matthew chapter 6, verses 1 to 3, Gospel of Matthew, chapter 6, verses 1 to 3. This is Jesus speaking. Beware of practicing your righteousness before other people in order to be seen by them. For then you will have no reward from your Father who is in heaven. Thus, when you give to the needy, sound no trumpet before you, as the hypocrites do in the synagogues and in the streets, that they may be praised by others. Truly I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give to the needy, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your giving may be in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. You ever be talking to somebody, and you're talking to them, and they say, oh, you know what so-and-so did? That was really great. And then you're in your head, you're like, wait a minute, no, that was actually me. You know that feeling that rises up in you that just wants to take credit for that? A great spiritual discipline can be in that moment to not take credit. Right? Or when you're doing something, right? When you're serving, or when you're giving, or you're being sacrificial, doing it in a way, as I said, not to be a hypocrite. He was talking about the way that the Pharisees would do things, you know? They would give something and they'd be like, look at me! I'm giving! Right? Something like that. That when you take those actions, when you do those things to do them in a kind of secret kind of way, God is getting glory. God is getting glory. God is honored in that. And as a spiritual discipline, it's great for building your humility. Right? Because we want to take credit. We're so good at it. Right? Credit taking is the opposite of thanksgiving, right? If you look at it that way. So we should be giving thanks. Instead, we like to what? Take credit. Right? So in terms of doing this, it's a great spiritual discipline, right? To build humility in our lives. So that's one. The other one is rest. Spiritual discipline. Rest. Rest. God hardwired that almost into the Jewish people, right? He has, as part of the Ten Commandments, he says, remember the Sabbath day, keep it holy. And when you think about it, so over how many days did creation take place? Over how many days? This is the Bible quiz portion.
Six.
Six. Everyone used to say six. Everyone says six.
Six.
And I used to, six, right? And one day I was sitting and I was like, that's wrong. I was like, that's wrong. Because on the seventh day, what did God do?
Rest.
So what did God create on the seventh day?
Rest.
Rest. God created rest on the seventh day. And as a spiritual discipline, this is great for us in the age we live in. This is a go, go, go age. We are constantly going. It's a three-go kind of age, right? I think it was like a two, I think up until I was about 21, it was a two-go kind of world. Somewhere in between there, it became a three-go. Go, 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 right? We are on the move. We are doing this. We are doing that. But you need to stop. Sometimes you need to stop and rest. And rest. And allow yourself to think upon the greatness and glory of God. So rest can be a great spiritual discipline for us as well. Father God, we thank you for this morning. We thank you for your word, which is faithful. We thank you for your word, which is true. Father, I pray that you would help us to shut out all the distraction, all the extra things. Sometimes good things that aren't the main thing. Help us this morning to think upon you, where we stand with you. Help us to know the reality of who we are in you. Help us, Spirit, to put the old self to death. Help us, Holy Spirit, as we live in a newness of life as a new creation. Help us to prioritize you first. And then help us to prioritize ourselves second. Physically, emotionally, spiritually, empower us.
Just move us and work in us this morning in your precious name. Let's just worship.